Let's go, it's the Whitey Show. Whitey Show.
Which part of man that ain't got time to shake your hand? Get that side check, put it in pockets like a sack.
God of War is back for the sixth time, or the fourth time, mattering if you count the actual side titles. Kratos is still an asshole, he's mean, but not quite as mean, I guess? This takes place before them all, even Chains of Olympus, which was originally the one that started it kind of all, or went back to the furthest in the past, but this takes place before everything, and it promises to show a softer, more human side to Kratos. Learn why he becomes enraged and hates the gods, why he killed his wife and daughter, why the series even began. These are the answers.
Have the visions ceased?
I see only you.
God, you will need this skill for the path ahead.
And what path is that?
Gameplay-wise, they switched up a few things in the controls, but the combat stays mostly the same for the most part. Using brutal-feeling combat to its advantage and big-scaled bosses, God of War doesn't fail there. It also added in a multiplayer to try to give it even more replay value. With a single-player package, a multiplayer package, will this be considered the best God of War yet? I'm gonna be honest here, been playing God of War since the beginning of time, or when they came out. God of War Ascensions, the newest title, has a ton of problems that I'm gonna go into, but before that, we start with the good to give some hope. First off, the strongest thing in this game is probably going to be the graphics. While they're not perfect, and I'll go into the issues I have with some of the graphical stuff later, the character models, animation effects look stunning. Truly the end of console type of looking game, and you gotta give Santa Monica credit there. Also, the raw, brutal feel of the combat is still there. While not very combo heavy, it still has enough combos that when you're in the midst of battle, you're slaughtering the baddies, it's awesome. From slicing and dicing to slamming your blades to the ground, ripping apart creatures and stomping in their face, the game does well to provide that brutal, badass feeling that the series has always provided. Also, another thing I love most is, well, the boss battles. True, one did really suck in this game, but for the most part, they're still really fun and at times stunning. They capture the essence of scale easily and the epicness so perfect. You gotta give props to the series for at least doing that. I also love the fact that the finishers are as brutal as ever. Such funness watching you beat the shit out of pieces of shit. Now the bad. The first thing that springs to mind is the camera. While I hardly think it's awful, since I played a billion action games in my time, at times the camera just moves a little bit too far back, making the fight seem more difficult than they should. Sure, most of the time it's fine, but sometimes it's annoying, but not as annoying as some reviewers are making it, in my opinion. I hated the puzzles though, and the platforming for this one. I figured I enjoy at least the platforming from the demo, but honestly, it just feels like crappy sections from a bad Prince of Persia game, and they just don't feel polished or fun. You'll fall off edges by accident, the game gives you no warning at times for quick time events that go along with the platforming, and the movements feel so stiff. Not a good idea to put much platforming when it was never good to begin with in God of War. Also, the puzzles just come off real lazy in this one. Just boring to do, honestly. Most are levers or time puzzles. Honestly, I just got so bored of them. I actually almost fell asleep on one, like the one I'm showing now. Oh my god, this was a chore to do and I was bored. It was like I was working. It was, ugh, blech. The glitches! I got over 5 glitches in the first 14 chapters. I even got one or two recorded right here. They usually are simple fixes by restarting the checkpoint, but it's just so annoying that they're even there, and it makes it feel like the game is rushed in. That's just not acceptable in a God of War series. Okay, now the ugly. You fanboys might get upset, but we're gonna talk about the problems that really did not or should not have been in this game. Because this fails to live up to any God of War title I expect to have in the epicness category. What the hell is up with the pacing? You could fight a great, epic boss battle for 10 minutes, then go through boring as hell platforming and puzzles for over an hour and a half. Bad pacing, and I thought God of War 3 had bad pacing, but this takes it to a new level. The story is absolutely dreadful. It's so light, and then when it tries to come in focus, it's terrible. I barely can tell or even call this a story. It's more like a storyboard, like, hey, this is what happened in God of War 1. Let's just get this guy there. Though, let's not make him care about any of the characters, and Kratos is still a fucking asshole and not even humanized. Terrible story. I want to skip every single cutscene. I played the multiplayer a bit, but honestly, there's nothing to talk about. It's average at best, using a rock, paper, scissor type gameplay where you guess what person is going to use to fight back on your combo. It's more of a chaotic version, kind of like Power Stone, just not nearly as fun. Just not even going to mention it. So it sounds like I'm not really enjoying this game much. Well, I'm about to hit you with the verdict, so here we go.
Which final man and ain't got time to shake your hand? Get that side check, put it in pockets like a sack.
Like I said, I've been a God of War fan since 1. I remember picking it up by accident, actually, the second day it was out, and just really loving it. Like, holding it like, this could be pretty cool. This guy looks a little crazy on the cover. I brought it home, playing my PS2. I mean, it was just amazing. And God of War 2, best game of my entire life! God of War 3 was a half and half for me. I still felt it was a great game at times, but definitely failed to live up to 1 and 2. But the boss battles were just, some of them were just epic. So with Ascensions, it was up in the air, you know? It could have been the revival for me. Could have been the, whoa, this is the God of War I've been waiting for. It came back. But it's not the case. Ascensions is essentially what I don't like in God of War. Why add platforming? You're not Prince of Persia. Stop it, Kratos! You can't even jump! Throwing an abundance of puzzles does not make them good. It makes them annoying. You didn't even do them well. It's just not a good idea. It's not a good idea, Santa Monica. The game averages anywhere from 5 to 7 hours. It's 30 chapters. At about 3 hours, I was at chapter 15, so you get an idea. And so many problems that could have easily been fixed, and I'm truly, 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 truly disappointed with God of War Ascension. You know what? I want to say just skip it. I honestly don't think it's worth even playing. But God of War fans or action fans, rent this title, try it out. You might enjoy it a lot more than me. I know some people that are. However, for everybody else that's not into action games and wants to try action games, I'm sorry. There's much better action games to try. Hell, try God of War 1 to 3 first. Or try what came out this year, like Metal Gear or DMC. I mean, these games are pure fun, and this is just riddled with problems. Riddled. So, I'm gonna go with skip it. Not burn it or anything. It's not an awful game, but it's just not memorable in any way. So, skip it for any fan, for action fans, or God of War. Try it out, rent it. I do not recommend buying it at all. I don't think it's worth it, and the multiplayer is definitely not going to keep you around, so rent it at best. Just skip it, though, if you want my honest opinion. And I thought Kratos was supposed to have this more human side in this one, but he didn't. Basically, it went from God of War 3,
Zeus, you're dead,
to this one where it's like,
I'm so angry, but not angry.
How is that any fucking different? How is that different? How is that more humanized? Now, I'm sure a lot of you fanboys of the God of War series are unsubscribing that button right now. All I gotta tell you is, I truly did admire that you watched my reviews and you enjoyed them. But if you're gonna unsubscribe for a difference of opinion, well,
fuck you, motherfucker!
Seriously, been doing this for years. Got unsubscribers, got subscribers. It's up to you. Or in Grado's tongue,
bye bye! This is my nice side!